I have sickle cell disease, SS. I didn't really understand it growing up. I just knew that I would get pain every so often. It didn't hit me that it was lifelong, and that I would be dealing with this. It was a hard pill to swallow when I realized that this is it.
Yeah, the life expectancy is limited mostly by the disease itself. They end up with kidney failure and sometimes stroke, sometimes heart attack as a result of this disease.
When you have sickle cell disease, it's not a good idea to become fatigued. You have to make sure that you're hydrated all the time. Extreme cold, extreme heat, even an extreme fluctuation in the weather. The patients go into crisis.
I don't know when it's gonna happen, so it's always been hard to plan for the future. My future is tomorrow, because I don't know when I will get a pain crisis, and then that'll be it. Then I have to go to the hospital.
There's over 140 million emergency department visits across the U.S. every year. It's important for us to understand what's happening in those visits, and research in that environment is critical.
I was excited to hear that there was a study for sickle cell, and that's what made me want to sign up to do it, because as much as I wish there would be something new, I am more than happy to help so that we can find something, even anything to help.
A little over a year ago, I was diagnosed with stage 4 melanoma. What I understood with melanoma was that there was no real treatment. You know, that chemotherapy and radiation weren't really working, and that it would be a life-altering disease.
Anytime a cancer metastasizes and it's in other organs, you know, that is a time to worry. If it had been left unchecked, it would have just kept spreading, and, you know, it could have meant the end for him.
Am I going to see my granddaughter grow up? I have an 18-year-old son. I have a 19-year-old daughter that are just starting their life. Where am I going to be there for them? You know, I just felt like a lot of things I haven't accomplished in life, and didn't know whether I was going to be able to do that.
Research offers new options, new hope, and I think that's why research is so important. Without it, we wouldn't be where we are. We wouldn't be advancing healthcare, and that's what we want to do, is advance healthcare.
Because at one time when I started, there was very little, and the median survival for these patients were 6 to 12 months. But nowadays, we have so many more treatments that are really changing the lives of our patients. Kevin chose to explore treatments, and we had a clinical trial that was available for him.
When I got to meet Dr. Kumar, I just had all the confidence in the world in her. And I just knew that everything was going to be okay. She has been just, you know, godsend.
You know, I remember in medical school, one of my professors saying, 50% of what you're learning is wrong, and it's up to you to figure out which 50%. Scientific inquiry is part of our responsibility as physicians and as healthcare providers.
What we hope will happen as a result of this is that they'll spend less time in the hospital, and these painful sickle cell crises, we hope that it will decrease the duration and the severity of these episodes so they can go about their lives.
So all of a sudden, in the last couple of years, immunotherapy, which are drugs that upregulate a patient's immune system, really gets it revved up, gets it going so that it actually attacks the cancer cells. So not only were we seeing the cancers disappearing, it was actually having a lasting effect.
I have hope every single day. When I go through the treatment, I go to work the day before, I go to work the day after. And even though I'm doing the immunotherapy, I don't have any restrictions. And it's just normal life. Like I didn't have cancer.
I can clearly notice a difference in that my stay was much shorter. I was out in 3 to 4 days. So it made a huge difference to have that peace of mind and to be somewhat normal would be amazing.
To participants like Jessica, thank you for taking part. Thank you for trusting us.
Because of Kevin, he changes the standard of care for so many other patients coming down the pipeline.
There were other people before me that got it to this point. If I can help get it to the next point, that to me, it's just amazing.
I am so grateful that I participated in this and it could actually lead to a huge breakaway. It makes me proud.
It's a great privilege for us to be able to be involved in this kind of thing.
And to MedStar, thank you for having this as part of your mission and vision and allowing us to participate.
To be able to possibly bring about new treatments, to bring about new hope, that's exciting.
Could this be the next magical thing that helps them feel better?
It's in our fingertips, right? I mean, when you see a patient that actually gets results like this that you never dreamed about before, you think, wow, this is attainable.
Thanks for giving me my life back.
Keep opening doors on research and thinking of other ways that we can live a better life.
Just want to thank you.
Thank you.